President Trump heads to his second G20 summit very shortly. According to the National Security Advisor, John Bolton, the schedule is packed, but the president is heading to Argentina without a key set of diplomatic tools in his arsenal. To tell us all about that, we have CNN senior political analyst John Avlon for our reality check. Hi, John.
Hey, Ali. So don't cry for me, Argentina, but buckle up, because the G20 in Buenos Aires is coming up, and the last time in Hamburg, it was a wild ride. This year, the Trump doctrine is clearer than ever. Trade wars, threats to allies, and as illustrated by the blind eye shown to the murder of Jamal Khashoggi, state-sanctioned murder will be considered a domestic offense as long as you're on the right side of U.S. policy. Affirming this was one of the most darkly remarkable op-eds ever written by Secretary of State that actually contains the words, "We don't condone Jamal Khashoggi's murder, but..." So if Trump rubs elbows with Saudi Crown Prince MBS at this year's G20, you might see the kind of closeness that only comes when you let someone get away with murder. Also on the agenda is another meeting with Vladimir Putin as Russia's conflict with Ukraine escalates amid deafening American silence. And we'll see if the president's admirable toughness on trade with China finally bears fruit. Now, to the president's friends, Trump is a disruptor. To his critics, he's a bull who carries his own China shop with him, to quote our colleague Doug Brinkley. But the chaos is compounded by the fact that the president goes into these meetings with shockingly few ambassadors deployed around the world. In fact, nearly half of the top jobs of the State Department are empty, and it's been that way for a while. According to the American Foreign Service Association, Trump only named 88 diplomatic nominees by the end of his first year in office. That's more than 40 fewer than President Obama at the same time. Still ignored are incredibly important countries. No ambassador to Mexico, for example, despite the president's relentless focus on illegal immigration. We have no ambassador to Turkey, or nuclear-armed Pakistan, or chaotic Libya. Our allies in Jordan still have no ambassador. Georgia and Estonia, often squarely in Vladimir Putin's crosshairs, have no ambassadors. No ambassador to Singapore, or the Association of Southeast Asian Nations. And Saudi Arabia just got a nominee 2 weeks ago. Trump's son-in-law Jared Kushner was handling it up until then. Of course, it's no surprise the president is going it alone. Remember this?
We don't need all the people that they want. The one that matters is me. I'm the only one that matters, because when it comes to it, that's what the policy is going to be.
The world is a dangerous place, as our president keeps reminding us, and it's absurd to think that he alone can fix it. Before we go, last night, a D.C. community board voted to rename the street directly outside the Saudi embassy in Washington, Jamal Khashoggi Way. Now, if the D.C. council approves the move, it'll send a stronger signal to the Saudis about American values, by way of a simple sign, than the Trump administration has dared to date. And that's your reality check.